The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Welcome back, my dear children. Listen to this inspiring quote. Your positive action combined with positive thinking results in success. In the previous class, we learned about non-cooperation movement and Quit India movement. From the previous class, you might have understood why did Gandhiji stop the non-cooperation movement. Yes, it is because of the Chowri Chowra incident. Today, we shall discuss a new topic, alternative path, Veritta Vazhigal. You all know very well how was Gandhiji's methods of struggle. Today, we are going to discuss on the topic about the people who was against the Gandhiji's methods of struggle. Now, just read a short note on Subhash Chandra Bose from page number 110. After reading, you might have understood that Subhash Chandra Bose had responded to Gandhiji's decision to withdraw the non-cooperation movement. Like this, you can see many such movements and persons who had difference of opinion towards Gandhian approach to the struggle for independence. Unlike Gandhiji's method of struggle, there were movements and individuals who worked for India's independence. Their aim was to achieve independence for India through the best possible means. Let us see in detail about it. 1928, Swaraj Party formed. The leaders of the Swaraj Party, C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru, who opposed Gandhiji's ideas of boycott movement. These leaders argued for making legislative assemblies as platforms for raising our voices instead of boycotting them, and they contested elections. Under the leadership of Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Rajguru and Sukhdev, the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association was formed in 1928. These leaders formed a military wing called Republican Army for armed rebellion. Their plan was to overthrow the colonial government through military action and establish a Federal Republic of Indian States. In Lahore, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev shot to kill Saunders, the police officer who was responsible for the Lathi charge that had led to the death of the national leader Lala Lajpat Rai. In the 1928, British government had a commission. Sir John Simon ആയിരുന്നു ആ കമ്മീഷന്റെ ഹെഡ്. ഇന്ത്യയിലെ അന്നത്തെ രാഷ്ട്രീയ സാഹചര്യങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ച് മനസ്സിലാക്കാനും ഇന്ത്യയിലെ ഭരണഘടനാ പരിഷ്കാരങ്ങൾ നടപ്പാക്കുന്നതിനെക്കുറിച്ച് ആലോചിക്കാനുമായിരുന്നു ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഗവൺമെൻറ് ഈ കമ്മീഷനെ അപ്പോയിൻ്റ് ചെയ്തത്. ഇന്ത്യയുടെ പ്രശ്നങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ച് പഠിക്കാൻ നിയോഗിച്ച ആ കമ്മീഷനിൽ ഒരൊറ്റ ഇന്ത്യക്കാർ പോലും ഇല്ലാത്തത് കാരണം ഇന്ത്യയിലെ രാഷ്ട്രീയ നേതാക്കൾ ആ കമ്മീഷനെ ബഹിഷ്കരിക്കാൻ തീരുമാനിച്ചു. ഈ കമ്മീഷൻ 1928 ഒക്ടോബർ 30 ലാഹോർ സന്ദർശിച്ചപ്പോൾ ലാലാ ലജ്പത് റായിയുടെ നേതൃത്വത്തിൽ സൈമൺ ഗോ ബാക്ക് എന്ന മുദ്രാവാക്യം വിളിച്ചും കരിങ്കൊടി കാണിച്ചും പ്രതിഷേധിച്ചു. ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് പോലീസിൻ്റെ ക്രൂരമായ ലാത്തി ചാർജിൽ പരിക്കേറ്റ് ലാലാ ലജ്പത് റായ് മരണപ്പെട്ടു. അതിന് കാരണക്കാരനായിട്ടുള്ള ഓഫീസറായിരുന്ന സാൻഡേഴ്സിനെയാണ് ഭഗത് സിംഗും കൂട്ടരും വധിച്ചത്. In addition, Bhagat Singh and Badkeshwar Dutt threw bombs at the Central Legislative Assembly to protest against the attempt to pass laws curtailing civil rights. നമുക്കറിയാലോ നിയമസഭകളിലാണ് നിയമങ്ങൾ പാസ്സാക്കുന്നത്. ഇന്ത്യക്കാർക്കെതിരെയുള്ള നിയമങ്ങൾ പാസ്സാക്കുന്ന ലെജിസ്ലേറ്റീവ് അസംബ്ലിയിലായിരുന്നു ബോംബെറിയാൻ ബോംബെറിഞ്ഞത്. They were arrested and sent to jail. on March 23, 1931, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev were hanged to death by the British government. അവരെ അറസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്ത് ജയിലിൽ അടച്ച് 1931 അവരെ തൂക്കിക്കൊല്ലുകയായിരുന്നു ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഗവൺമെൻറ് ചെയ്തത്. ലെറ്റ് എസ് സീ സം ഓഫ് ദ റവല്യൂഷണറി ഓർഗനൈസേഷൻ ആൻഡ് ദെയർ ലീഡേഴ്സ്. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ, അഭിനവ് ഭാരത് സൊസൈറ്റി, വി ഡി സവർക്കർ. സെക്കൻഡ്, അനുശീലൻ സമിതി, വരീന്ദ്രകുമാർ ഘോഷ് ആൻഡ് പുലിൻ ബിഹാരി ദാസ്. തേർഡ് വൺ, ഖദർ പാർട്ടി, ലാല ഹർദയാൽ. ഇന്ത്യൻ റിപ്പബ്ലിക്കൻ ആർമി, സൂര്യ സെൻ. ദീസ് ആർ ദി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് റവല്യൂഷണറി ഓർഗനൈസേഷൻ ഫോംഡ് അറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ടൈം. ടേക്കിംഗ് ക്യൂ ഫ്രം ദ റഷ്യൻ റവല്യൂഷൻ, സോഷ്യലിസ്റ്റ് ഐഡിയോളജീസ് സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ടു സ്പ്രെഡ് ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ ഇൻ 1930s. സോഷ്യലിസ്റ്റ് ഐഡിയോളജീസ് ഇൻഫ്ലുവൻസ്ഡ് എ സെക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് കോൺഗ്രസ് ആക്ടിവിസ്റ്റ്, ജവഹർലാൽ നെഹ്റു, സുഭാഷ് ചന്ദ്രബോസ്, ജയപ്രകാശ് നാരായൺ and Aruna Asafali led the Congress socialist fraction within the Indian National Congress. Indian National Congressil ninnondu thanne socialist ideology follow cheyidirna nethakkalayirunnu ivarella. Under the chairmanship of Jayaprakash Narayan, the Congress Socialist Party was formed in 1934. Congress Socialist Party played a decisive role in the Quit India movement. When Gandhiji and other top leaders of the Congress were arrested, socialist party leaders like Jayaprakash Narayan, Aruna Asafali led the movement from their hideouts. Now let us discuss the role of Subhash Chandra Bose in Indian National Movement. At various stages of the national movement, Subhash Chandra Bose opposed Gandhiji's decisions and views. Quitting the Congress, he formed a political party called Forward Bloc. He took the charge of the Indian National Army, INA, formed by Raj Bihari Bose to attain freedom for India. He formed a provincial government for Free India in Singapore with the aim of forcing the British to quit India. As you all know, the Indian National Army had a woman wing called Jhansi Regiment. Captain Lakshmi was in charge of this regiment. Captain Lakshmi in Malayalam. With the support of the Japanese army, the Indian National Army marched to the east-west border of India and hoisted an Indian flag in Imphal. Let us discuss the next topic, movements of workers and peasants. As you know, after Russian Revolution, socialist ideologies influenced the Indian people. Socialist ideologies helped the formation of various labor and peasant movements in India. These are the important labor union formed in India. First one, Ahmedabad Textile Association. Ahmedabadile textile industryil joli cheyidirna thozhilaligalude sanghadana. And Madras Labor Union. Madrasile thozhilaligalude sanghadana. Ee sanghadanakal ayirunnu thozhilali sanghadanakalayi Indiyil aadyamayi roopam kondathu. In 1920, the All India Trade Union Congress, AITUC, was formed under the leadership of N.M. Joshi and Lala Lajpat Rai. Objectives of AITUC: to organize and act as a working class, to facilitate Indian working class to cooperate with the working class outside India, to participate actively in the Indian freedom struggle. These are the main objectives of AITUC. Indian farmers also realized the importance of an organized struggle and started peasant movements. Example, All India Kisan Sabha was formed in Lahore under the leadership of N.G. Renga. A farmer's manifesto, which included all the basic demands of the Indian peasants, was prepared in the All India Kisan Samadhi Conference held in Bombay. These are the demands of the farmers included in the manifesto: reduce 50% of land tax and lease charge, right of debts, cancel feudal taxes, ensure minimum wage for agricultural workers, recognize peasant unions. Indian farmers and laborers started their protest against the British government in various parts of the country. Examples: agitations and their places, Tebaga struggle in Bengal, Telangana struggle in Andhra Pradesh, naval mutiny in Bombay. Now let us discuss the last topic of the lesson, towards independence. As you all know, after Second World War, most of the European countries lost their economic dominance. Due to financial crisis, Britain lost its capacity to maintain the colonies. At that time, most of the European colonies in Asia and Africa intensified their freedom movements, and Soviet policy and American policy against colonialism forced the Britain to free India from their clutches. At the same time, the new British government was formed under the leadership of Clement Attlee, the Labour Party leader. He was a sympathizer to India, also expedited our independence from colonial rule. All India League, under the leadership of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, raised claims for a separate country called Pakistan. At that time, Lord Mountbatten was appointed as the Viceroy of India to deliver freedom to India, addressing the question of partition. He argued that freedom for India was impossible without partition. And to support this argument, he prepared a strategy called Mountbatten Plan. These are the important provisions of the Mountbatten Plan. To form a separate country in Muslim majority area as per the Muslims' wish. To divide Punjab and Bengal. To conduct a referendum to determine whether to add Northwest Frontier Province to Pakistan or not. To appoint a commission to determine the borders in Punjab and Bengal. Indian National Congress and All India Muslim League approved this plan. But the nationalists like Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan strongly opposed it. In 1947, when the British Parliament passed the Indian Independence Act, two free nations, India and Pakistan, came into existence. Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of independent India. The freedom we attained on 15th August 1947 is the outcome of the Indian National Movement, inspired by various streams of ideas and ideologies. Okay, what all things we have discussed in this lesson? Non-cooperation and Khilafat movement, civil disobedience movement, and early struggles of Gandhiji, Quit India movement, alternative path, movements of workers and peasants, at last towards independence. I hope it is clear. Go through the text well. Clarify your doubts with me. Read and study well. Okay, thank you.